outside Brywell Police Station with Mayor Marvin Rees. Marvin, what did you think when you saw the scenes unfolding last night? And have you ever seen anything like that in Bristol before?
Well, I was disgusted, and we absolutely condemn what happened in the city last night. I mean, we have seen conflict before in the city, obviously. But last night, I think, I would say, was an expression of political illiteracy. I don't care if people say that they're claiming here to oppose the bill. What they've done is just run an event, or, you know, engaged in violence that is going to be used for those who support the bill. So the illiteracy in that front is just staggering. And also, you know, we face real challenges in the city around homelessness, food poverty, fuel poverty, domestic violence. You know, this has done nothing to help us meet the real challenges facing people in Bristol right now as we come through COVID and look at an economic depression in front of us. So yeah, I'm very little patience. These people should not even be mentioned in the same breath as the very legitimate debate there is to be had over the bill, which has all sorts of points of concern. But they shouldn't be offered any sort of status in that debate. So we're horrified, we condemn it. And as a city, we need to stand together and reclaim our story from these people who tried to hijack it from us yesterday.
And is that how you say it's really a minority of people who hijacked a legitimate protest yesterday?
Well, that's what all the evidence points to at the moment. A number of people who've come along, perhaps seen an opportunity, they've seen another demo they can attend, and taken the opportunity to indulge their fantasies of being revolutionaries and attack symbols of the state.
And where do you go from here to just try and unite people once again in what has been one hell of a year and quite a divided year in many ways?
Well, I think over the last year we've shown ourselves to be an incredibly united city. We've faced incredibly tense situations, and we've come through without violent conflict. And actually, it's been a real source of pride for me, as I've spoken nationally and internationally, that as a city we've been able to hold ourselves up and say that's how you deal with difference, that's how you deal with tension without it descending into conflict. These people last night tried to take that from us, and that actually, I hope, is a rallying point for the city, that we do not allow them to do so, and we absolutely go back to reasserting who we are. Look at what we've done in the last few days with Bristol Remembers, you know, a city-wide effort to recognise all those people who have experienced loss over this last year, how we come together to support each other through that loss, to find our perseverance, our character, and our hope in all that. That's been very special. And what we need to do is say that's where we are in our story as a city right now. We're coming together to support each other. We're not going to let these people hijack our story and our city from us.